Howdy, howdy, Javad is here and let's learn everything that you need about curtain walls. Curtain walls are our walls but in different way, and they give us more potential to create different things and really amazing things with them for our facades, for our interior partitions and those things. But first of all, let's talk about the different elements in one curtain wall. In curtain wall, we have three different elements. We have panels, we have grids, and we have mullions. Each curtain system or curtain wall has different elements, and those that I mentioned are the elements that we have in curtain. By default, in Revit template, you have three different types of curtain walls. You have curtain wall, you have exterior glazing, and you have a storefront. In the first one, we only have a panel, and we only have the border grids. In the second one, we have some interior grids too. And the third one, we have panels, we have grids underneath the mullions, and we have mullions and our profiles too. And also in Revit, we have two ways to create our curtain walls. We have a manual way and manual gridding of and placing mullions in on our curtain walls. And we have an automatic way. Let's do a manual way, and we will talk about the automatic way too. For example, let's click on wall and let's go to the curtain wall, which is a default and empty place in here. And let's do some modification in here. To do that, you have two tools in here, curtain grid and mullion in here. Click on curtain grid and you can place your grid very easily, horizontal grids and vertical grids very easily. Just click once and you have your grids, for example, this one and this one. And for example, in here, I just want to place one grid between this one and this one. So I need to change the placement in here, for example, to this, and I can have something like this. Or you can select the whole intersections, and you can specify except this one, for example, and then you will have something like this. But I am okay with this. Let me select this one and let's change the placement of this one. 2 meter and 2 meter. The tip is here, if you can select your grids and panels, make sure to activate the select peel elements in here, and you need to press tab to switch between different selection of your curtain walls too. After placement of your grids, now you can place your mullions on them. To do that, click on mullion in here, select the type of mullion that you want to use, for example this one, and let's assign them one by one. Or you can use other kind of placements like this, or you can place all of them at the same time. But for the interior part, let's place, for example, a square and square profiles in here. And you can see there are different profiles in here. Now let's create an automatic curtain wall. To do that, create a simple curtain wall in here and click on edit type. Make sure to create a duplicate from it. And then in the layout part, you have different kinds of layouts: fixed number, fixed distance, minimum and maximum spacing. Let's put it on, for example, minimum spacing in both vertical grid and horizontal grid. And let's put it on, for example, something like 0.5 and 0.5. Click on OK. And now you will have your grids in here. And also you can change the justification in here. Let me put it on a bigger number, maybe 1. That would be better in here. And we can have our justification in here. For example, you want to have the decimals at the end or at the beginnings. For example, let's put both of them at the beginning, and that's great. And then you can go to the edit type again, and in here we have the exact same thing for our mullions too. We have vertical and horizontal mullions. Vertical mullions are the vertical mullions, and horizontal mullions are horizontal mullions, but we have three different mullions for each one. We have interior type. Let's put the interior part on a square. And now we have our border. Border 1 Let's put the border one on something else. Let's select this one. Let's click on edit type and select the border one on something like maybe rectangle mullion, and let's place it in border 1, 2. Click on apply. You can see border 1 is for the bottom and left, and border 2 is for right and top. So make sure to adjust them and assign them correctly. And also, if you want to delete one mullion, for example, in here, or one grid in here, you can press tab in here. If you can select it, make sure to select pin elements are on in here, and then select it, and then unpin it, and then you can delete it very easy. But the grid doesn't delete, so you need to select the grid again, click on add remove, and click in here again, and now you have this kind of panel in this part. So it is a automatic curtain wall with some modification inside of it. By default, when you are creating curtain walls inside another wall, for example, let's put it on level 2, it will embed the curtain wall inside the basic wall or a stack wall that you have like this. But if it didn't work, make sure to go to the edit type and see that automatically embed is checked on or it is off. When it is off, it doesn't embed the curtain wall inside other walls in Revit. You have some settings about the panels, and you can import some panel family too to change the panels. If you just want to change one panel, press tab twice or three times to select the panel, and then you can change the panel. From here, you can place some walls inside it, or even you can place some other curtain walls inside it. So that's a really good thing to do. And you can place some walls in here, or I have some additional panels in here, and you can place some panels in here. Placing doors and windows are same, so you need to select the panel and assign some curtain doors and curtain windows to the panel to place new things. And if you want to assign a panel to all of the panels in one type, you need to select the curtain wall and go to the edit type, and in here change the panel, for example, to maybe solid. And now with some modification, you can have these solid panels and solid walls for drywalls or those kind of things very easily. Sometimes if you need to change your mullion placement and you need to move it, when you select them and you are trying to move them, it doesn't work. So make sure to select one mullion, click on select mullion, put on grid, and then hide them with HH. And then you need to select the grid instead, and you can move it right now. And then click on reset, and now you have your mullions in another placement. If this video has been helpful so far, please don't forget to like this video to help YouTube reach this video to more people. Okay, let's go back to the tutorial. When you have some corners in curtain walls, it doesn't work great and the way that you expect. There are some way to fix it. Just go to the plan view and select one of these mullions in here, right click, and then select the select mullion and put it on grid. Let's go to 3D, and all of them are pinned, so unpin them and delete them. Let's go to the level 1 again, right click on one of these mullions, go to the select mullion, select all of the mullions on grid and unpin them, but this time change the type of them, for example, to one of these corner mullions. Let's put it on L mullion, and now you fix the corner of these L-shape wall with L-corner mullion. Advanced tip in here that you can create spider glasses very easily too. For example, I have a family. I will put the family in the description. You can download it, and you just need to select your curtain wall. And let me make this one a little bit bigger and go to the edit type. Let's create a duplicate from it. And you need to put the curtain panel on the spider panel and click on OK, and now you have your wall with the spider grips in here. You can press space and see the details in here too. So that was it. I hope this video has been helpful for you. If it was, please don't forget to like this video. And this was the 8th session of Revit Architecture for Beginners course. If you want to learn Revit, make sure to check this playlist that I will put in here. And I will see you on the next session.